Hey everybody, how are we doing tonight? I had a last minute audible change because I realized that Tadpole Tales came out today. Tadpole Tales is a completely free, hand-drawn clean-em-up that released on Steam today. It is... like, you can download it right now. I can link the itch as well as Steam. But it looks great. It's something I've had on my radar for a minute now. It's a shoot-em-up, but it's a clean-em-up. I'm going to run the intro once more because I had it pulled up to make sure everything was running right. A myth from the past said that there was a beautiful river inhabited by frogs. Its water was crystal pure, and all the animals were living peacefully. With King Froggo on the throne, the river was always carefree and blessed with flowers and sunshine. But one day, three monsters with great corruption, seeing the untouched beauty of the river, wanted to claim it as their own, intoxicating everything around it. And when all hope was lost, a tiny brave tadpole breaks its shell. Wiggling its tiny tail, it attempts to defeat the great evil that now plagues the river. The tadpole tries to wash the toxins away and save the precious river they call home. Alright, fellas. Real quick. Thank you, Dinny FM, for the follow. I appreciate it. I didn't have it up on this little simple version of my, setup. Because I originally planned to do Supercross tonight. But I saw this was out, so I had to first. I appreciate the follow. Thank you. Let's get it cracking. Okay, I don't know. Okay, it's WASD in space. So I may have to... okay, I can use arrow keys. Alright. Clean them up. Oh, this is cute. But yeah, I mean... can you guys hear it? It's really quiet for me. I think it might just be my headphones. There we go. Entirely hand-drawn. It's awesome. Good music too. How's everybody doing tonight? My sleep schedule's a mess. Like, absolutely destroyed. I went to bed at like 7 in the morning. Yesterday I woke up at like 4:30 in the afternoon, and then today I woke up at 11 a.m. So I'm running on like 4 hours, 4.5 hours of sleep, because I probably started laying down in bed around 6:30. So, you know, it's always up in the air what time you actually fall asleep. And then you have daylight savings time, ending, starting, whichever, Saturday. So add that to everything. Dude, this music's actually really nice. Duck time. Whoa. Oh, popped. Oh, that was it. All right, here we go. We really gotta buckle up. All right, two hits. I got ducked. Two hits. We're beating this. I was like Monster Energy is gonna be funny. But I wanted to play something that I, like, knew that I'd be, like, proud that I shone a light on. There's something really funny about Supercross. Monster Energy Supercross. Wait, no, it's Monster Energy Supercross, the official video game 4 is the full title. There's something really funny about it that I'm excited to show you once I switch over to it that I noticed right before I started streaming. That's like absolutely believable, but I wish it was unbelievable. It's hard to explain. You're gonna have to see it. Just wait. Just wait. You'll see. You'll see. It's absolutely. You'll see. I don't know how to explain it. I'm just gonna stop talking. All right. Here we go. Whoa. Oh, shit. Oh, that was like... Okay, I gotta start moving. Damn it. That sounds like, we're getting better. Sounds like, Majora's Mask. Blowing up the Deku snot balloons. I always thought they were like snot balloons, but they're probably not snot. All right, I wonder if there's extra heart ability. I mean, it shows 4, so there's gotta be, but maybe it comes from beating the boss. Because I think I was at 100%. Like, 100% enemy clear. Dude. 2 hits is brutal. They said that they were going for, like, GBA vibes. Oh! Look at that! Somebody's listening. Look at that. And I tadpole leveled up, dude! Asking you shall honestly. Alright, I just lost it. Yeah, anytime you wanna do that again, whoever's watching and pulling the strings on my file. Here we go, and move. It changed the look of the projectiles. I wonder if it actually was a damage boost. That I don't know. Hey, how you doing, Maria? Last minute audible here. I was excited for this. I've had it on my Steam wishlist for like a minute now. Damn it. And I didn't realize it came out today. Just finished The Social Network. Is that scene still as good as I remember it being? The Andrew Garfield, when he walks into the office and finds out that he's been... What was it? Spoilers for the 11-year-old Social Network right now. Was it his board seat or his shares? Yeah, what did they do? Did they, like, they devalued his position in the company? I forget exactly what the His shores were cut from 30% to 0.3%. Yeah, crazy. 0.03%. All right, even worse. And it was all Sean Parker's fault. Diluted his shares. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Classic scene. One of the best. Ever. Honestly, like, deserves a rewatch. That scene alone. Gotta say, Rooney Mara is hot. I think she's the hottest female celebrity. I don't know her face by name. I mean, maybe though. I'm not gonna say you're wrong. Are you kidding me? I should not have went into that. Dude, this is a hard, hard, hard 1-2 punch. Having to dodge the missiles, then go right. She's engaged to Joaquin Phoenix? Really? Wow. Okay. Man, sometimes those hitboxes, I'm sorry. Did we make it over 2 minutes that time? Okay, we made it much farther. Man, RTX voice is cool. I'm like slamming on my keyboard because I can't use a controller. And it doesn't even pick up the click-clack at all. There we go. That was a gimme. That was a... You've died quite a few times here, buddy. Take this golden dragonfly. Like the P-Wing in Mario. The new Mario games where they're just like, hey, here. We can tell you need this, desperately. There was some Hulu movie. What was the name of it? Kids See Ghost, if you're here, the one that Ben wanted to watch and then I completely forgot on Wednesday to ping him to say I'm ready to watch it, even though I was ready to watch it and I was up till 6 a.m. playing Loop Hero. Because I still do want to watch it. I just like watched 5 seconds of that trailer and saw Ken Jeong at a diner counter. Yeah, the one with that guy. You know, the guy wearing the jacket. Frank Grillo, movie's called Boss Level. Hell yeah. That looks right up my alley. Okay. Seems so cute. Okay, you don't need to stop shooting. You move fast. Let's go! Oh, duck down! Huh? What's next? Hulu original Boss Level. I watched literally 4 seconds of the trailer and went, yeah, sure, I'm in. And then turned it off and I don't want to know anything else about it. I don't even know who Frank Grillo is by name. He is that guy. He wears that jacket. Okay, this new guy. New guy alert. Aw. I wasn't about to risk it. I'll regret it later. Shoe time? Boot time? Cat time. Maybe like a weasel? Oh, come on. That was like a trial by fire. They didn't give you enough time to learn that. You just had to... Oh my god. Dude, some of these projectile placements. Look at him. Alright, please, game. Begging for a health. Begging for a heart right now. Begging. Begging and pleading. Just send that golden dragonfly right this way. Holy moly. Holy moly. Whoa. Okay, we got trouble. Please, 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 please. Don't squander it. This song's really good. I like it a lot. This is going on the pre-show playlist. If I can find an MP3 for it. Alright, didn't love that hitbox. Didn't love that hitbox. Dude. Oh, this is bad vibes. We got it. 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 Just can't get hit. even one time. Cannot get hit. Oh boy. Here we go, folks. Digging the minimal layout today. Yeah, I got a, I got a theme for the main game. I hesitate to say main game. I got the theme for the game that I was intending to play today. But I realized that this was out and I wanted to play it really bad. Right there. All right, we're getting this. This is it. I don't like when streamers have like minimal themes like this that cover the screen. And I know that mine is right now, and it just mildly irritates me. And so that's why I do the layout, and I do the, like, smaller game window, but you can see the whole thing unobstructed. I just prefer being able to see the whole game. So. I used this when I played Resident Evil 2 in the middle of the night, Sunday. That was the grand unveiling of this minimalist theme. I think it looks pretty nice. I am in desperate need of a heart. Would love a secondary heart right now. We got Duckman. Whoa, okay, that was really close. That was like, I should not count on that ever happening again. Let's go. I got his number. I really want to see what four hearts looks like. It's like, okay, just play better then. That weave was a good start. On the play better front. What is this thing? A weasel? God. Alright, alright. Not a fan of that one. I'm tense. I am not gonna lie to you. I am anxious. I'm mad now. You can't go down! Because you get hit by the bomb and you- that- I think you gotta just really fly through it forward. I don't know. That's a tough situation. That's a tricky, tricky spot. So it looks like they're, like, I was thinking maybe hitting all of the, like, you know, flies or ladybugs as they fly across the screen, maybe that's what triggers the hearts, but it looks like it is entirely random. Welcome to the stream, H. Don. We're playing Tadpole Tales. Hopefully I can get a fourth heart. I want to see it so bad. I want to see the final. Yeah, we're weaving. The hitboxes are a little funky. Can't lie. I have an audience. I do have an audience. You're right. Grace and Tomo. Welcome, Grace and Tomo. It is so cute. I hesitate to, like, drop the, it's like Cuphead because of the just hand-drawn aesthetic, but it has, like, a commitment to charm in its animations that really does remind me of something like Cuphead. It's like a cartoon, honestly. It's like a playable cartoon. That this could have been it. This could have been the four heart Tadpole upgrade. Franco, I don't know if you were here at the very beginning. This is entirely free on Steam. This is, the studio's been working on it for a minute and they just put it out today. Yeah. So. Check it out. I feel bad. You know, Drugs pops in here and like multiple games he's been like, dude, I actually like that. I want to play it. Like Teamfight Manager, he was talking to me the other night and like would love to play Teamfight Manager, but he only has a Mac and an iPad. And he's like, I wish they would just make these apps. But like historically, very, very, so, I mean, likes playing games. Why can't they make Steam games available on Mac? They can. It just, it's a different system architecture, so it requires different like programming. You kind of have to port it over. And sometimes it's just like out of the realm of understanding of developers, especially it just takes time and effort that they may not have and they want to push the game out and etc, etc. And it's just the market share of Apple devices in the gaming space like that is so low that it's like, what benefit are we really getting from, you know, dumping all these resources into a Mac port? But that being said, there are Steam games on Mac. Like, don't be misled. They're not super common, especially, I mean, Rhythm Doctor's on Mac. You can play Rhythm Doctor right now on your Mac, on Steam. Speaking of Rhythm Doctor, I realized today there is no Cyclonials next week. There is a mid-season break next Wednesday, so there will not be a Cyclonials. I know. Don't talk about it. There will not be a Cyclonials. See? Don't talk about it. Let's go. Four farts into the final boss. No Cyclonials next Wednesday. We're a big boy. Big old boy. So, next Wednesday, I might do, like, a Twitter vote. I don't know. I already have it. Like, I know what I want to play, and we'll probably just wind up going with it. Ooh, triple shot. So next Wednesday, instead of Cyclonials, I'm thinking games we all like. Oh, your hitbox is massive, though. Yeah, hope you were able to look at his big mouth before it was gone forever. I want to do Rhythm Doctor and Teamfight Manager, I'm thinking. Next Wednesday, do a two-game stream. I think those are like two hits that are fun to watch as well as play. That kind of make it, this is hard, like the colors, the kind of gray black on the purple. I wish there was some sort of hit recognition, maybe like a flash or something to kind of signify like, hey, you're doing damage here. Okay, let's go. So yeah, I'm considering Teamfight and Rhythm Doctor for next Wednesday night. I think that those are fun. If you have other recommendations, let me know. Otherwise, I think that's what we'll consider locking in. there was that hit recognition. I was like, it's just, I hope that was like a halfway point and not like a, oh yeah, he's feisty. And with the tadpole's last few breaths, it finally managed to wake the giant toad from its slumber. All the animals are so thankful to this little tadpole for saving them, so they threw a party. They managed to rid the river from its toxins, and now it's clean, pure, and with more friends. Thank you for playing and cleaning our river. It is up to all of us to protect our Earth, just like this little tadpole and the friends it made along the way. Let's go with a message. Little environmentally conscious message at the end. Man, that was great. Dedicated to Anna and Rebecca. Thank you for playing. That was great. Nine-minute clear. You've unlocked expert mode. You can play at nighttime, and only the bosses will drop hearts. Do I dare? Do I dare run an expert run? It said nighttime. We gotta see the new visuals. Look at the vibes here. Clean them up. Only the bosses drop hearts, so you think that's on a boss clear, it drops a heart? So it's like, so long as you no-hit a boss, you're getting an upgrade? That's actually kind of a cool system. I mean, it's tough, but it makes sense why there's four hearts now, because if you no-hit boss one and no-hit boss two, you're the big frog going into the final engagement. Honestly, the darker water, the projectiles look better. To me, at least. But we know how my eyes are. Which is to say, not good. I have a contact for a optometrist that takes the, like, New York State Medicaid that I'm on because I don't have my job. I don't have a job. I'm no longer at my old job. But I just haven't called them because their office closes at like 1 p.m. on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And I've just been asleep. So hopefully, somebody has to remind me. No, I just have to do it. But I have the availability to do it, and I have, I think, like, through New York State, like, Medicaid insurance, I get a free eye exam and a free pair of glasses, which is, like, bonkers. I went to the urgent care once because I had, like, bad chest pains. Turned out to be muscle stuff. But, like, didn't even get a bill. I feel like I should have, but it just never came. Yeah. I'm into expert. It just gives it to you like that. Speaking of my job, March 12th, today is the 1 year anniversary since the last day I went into Costco to work. After I left work 1 year ago today, I was like, yeah, there's no way. It was a very, like, no chance moment. There was, like, a line out the door. For people that don't know, I worked in the Manhattan Costco. And it's, like, all the way over by on the East River. And there was a line out the door, out to First Avenue for Costco. And it was like, no. And they were letting in, you know, however many people at a time. And it was like one of the first days that we were limiting people in and you had to have a mask. And well, no, you didn't have to have a mask yet. Oh, that's not fair. That's not fair. They said only bosses. Only bosses drop hearts. Well, there goes the game's 10. Yeah, I was one of the only people wearing a mask. I went into work with gloves and a mask that a coworker gave me, like an older coworker that was like, I'm not about to get sick. And I wonder how she's doing. Jewel. Was there always a timer in the bottom left? Was I just like too zoned in? Or is that new for expert? New for expert? Okay. That was bad. That was my fault. That wasn't a cheap hit. That was absolutely my fault. But yeah, I have been home helping my grandma for 1 year as of today. Crazy to think about. Maria, are you still here? Remember when I was texting you saying that I think a little worldwide lockdown would do the world some good? Like people need to just relax a little bit. I was like, you know what, maybe like quarantining for a couple weeks, people aren't allowed to leave their homes, would be like a good thing. Like, I think we need this. And you know what? I was right. As I always am. Nah, I had tickets to the format, Ben. I had tickets to two nights of My Chemical Romance in their hometown. Who knows if those shows are gonna happen? Like, ever. I mean, both of those, like the format and My Chemical Romance, like they were doing like an arena hall tour last year. I mean... Maybe Gerard Way's been really putting in work. And pop. Ah. All things considered, this boss kind of like cool visually, but it only has like 3 attacks. It has tongue, it has mouth bubbles, and then it has side bubbles. I wish that phase 2 like introduced, I don't know, something else. I'm an expert. No secret, hidden expert boss. Unbelievable. Cadbury mini eggs is what I just put in my mouth. Act Esper. Really good job with the music. I thought they were gonna add they weren't gonna add the dedicated onto expert mode for a second. Faster time too. Honestly, kind of a lackluster expert. Air quotes. Like, not only did like I'd get a heart when it said I wouldn't, but 853. Oh, hey, it just hyperlinked Act Esper's YouTube page. So cool, guys. That was Tadpole Tales. Here's the itch link. It's free. It's fun. All right. Let us do this. Pull this down. Oh, I gotta score it. Right. Let me get that all set up. That felt good. I know it's only been Saturday, but it's felt like a long time since I've beaten the game. You know? Anybody know what I mean? Okay. Sorry, I'm writing this stuff out. I'll actually let you see it. We gotta put Teamfight Manager in. We gotta put Loop Hero in. Loop Hero's been taking over my life, by the way, guys. I'll just show you really fast. You're about to be absolutely disgusted. Like, this is disgusting. What I'm about to show you is... I can't zoom in, but... Can you see it? And like you might go, okay, well, he's idled a lot, so like that's got to be part of it. But I have a lot to say about Loop Hero. I will probably beat it tomorrow. And so tomorrow night's stream definitely will chat about my thoughts on this game. In the meantime, here's a picture of my map entirely filled on a run. Okay. Anyway. Tadpole Tales. I mean, really quick. Cons. Iffy hitboxes. I know that's kind of like a... like slightly... like just get good excuse. But it's true. I think with something that's hand-drawn like that... the hitboxes, while they might be, you know, rigid and fair, they almost feel tougher to gauge just by virtue of the hand-drawn animation. There were a couple of situations that bugged me. I can't even, like, call this a con, necessarily. Well, I can say expert mode ? There was no difference. There was no difference at all. I mean, at least it gave us the night visuals, but it wasn't expert mode. The enemies didn't have new patterns. The bosses didn't have new attacks, nothing of that nature. Nothing changed in that regard. Pros are obvious. Just like playing a Saturday morning cartoon. It was just gorgeous. Gorgeously animated. And that encapsulates everything. I mean, the music had like morning cartoon vibes. It was like a very good song, but it wasn't like chiptune-y gamey in a way that a lot of, you know, free-to-play and indie games feel. It had a bounce to it that felt like almost an end credits song of a show. It really, like, just the whole aesthetic package is incredible. The aesthetic package is incredible. It had a meaningful twist on the shoot 'em up genre being a clean 'em up and ending with the, listen, guys, protect our waters, help clean up. You know what I mean? It was really nice, both from like a gameplay perspective and a visual perspective, but it just, it worked for me really well. I don't want to say quick and easy because it wasn't easy, but it's free. It's free. What can I say? It's like Pear Potion. Pear Potion is at $2. Play it. Tadpole Tales, it's free. Play it. Why not? I'll fill this out a little bit more. But I mean, off the top of my head, I really, besides those two, iffy hitboxes, and like that also takes into account like that weasel boss had a couple of, like, when he would shoot the three-pronged attack, like the three projectiles, and you were dodging the bomb, there were moments where it was just like you just had to watch yourself get hit, which I think is frustrating in a game that only gives you two lives. Yeah, I mean, I liked the evolutionary aspect of getting hearts and actually physically and visibly seeing your tadpole grow was awesome. I mean, the only con is I wish there was more. You know? It's like... bombs looked wide enough. They are. Exactly. Yeah. They did. They did in multiple instances. They looked that first time. When they first popped up, I was like, okay, I'll just weasel my way right through. And no. Good luck. I think that this is going to fly under radars because it is a free game. Because it is something that, you know, is just, like, if you go on Steam is learning about this game. Even Steam has no idea what's going on. I think that the devs almost, like, either sold themselves short, or maybe they needed to get a different publisher or something, because there's something here. And, I mean, obviously, I hope that this is a proof of concept that's going to get a developer. I think of, like, Dotemu, like the people that are doing the Ninja Turtles Shredder's Revenge and did Streets of Rage 4. Imagine if these guys, like, got their hands on, like, what's that game? What's that? Let me see if I can. This one. Okay, this is a bad example. But what if the devs got their hands on, like, Cho Aniki, which is the shoot 'em up with the big muscular dudes? Do you guys know what I'm talking about? Let me get a YouTube video so you can see what I'm talking about. I'm looking at it on my other monitor right now. Whoa, really loud. Like, bad example. Definitely not what this developer should be making a game based off of. But, like, you think about, like, that publisher in particular that's working with devs on, you know, like, modernizing and revitalizing these classic franchises. And there's gotta be a shoot 'em up somewhere buried that this team can get a real crack at, because the animation's incredible, the music's incredible. It was really great. I loved it. I really did. Again, I hesitate to even put that in cons, because it's like, I don't know what was going on behind the scenes. Maybe this is a proof of concept. Maybe this is whatever it is. So where does it sit? Man, Pear Potion's good. Pear Potion has more to it, and I can't... I can't not give the edge to Pear Potion just because of my tie to it now. Like, on my list, I'm sitting on a world record that I haven't posted yet. I think it's got to go one below. I think if it had, you know, maybe 45 minutes more content, had a few more phases, you know, I mean, I don't want to, like, theory craft what the game could have been, so I'll stop where I'm at. But, yeah,